In question number 6, a sphere of radius r is submerged in a liquid of density rho. The force exerted by liquid on upper half of sphere at the position shown in figure is, assume atmospheric pressure to be 0. So if I analyze the situation, suppose this is the upper part of the hemisphere and suppose this is the level of liquid. So this is a distance r and the radius of the sphere is r. So again, this separation is r. Let if F1 is the force exerted on the upper surface and F2 is the force exerted on this projected area of the hemispherical surface, let this is F2, then F2 is equal to the pressure at this point from the top of the surface is rho g and h is 2r. This is the pressure into projected area. So that is pi into r square. So the force acting at this point is F2 and it is equal to rho g into 2r dot pi r square. The buoyancy acting on this hemisphere is equal to weight of liquid displaced. So that is equal to rho into volume of liquid displaced 2 by 3 pi r cube into g. So I can say that buoyancy is equal to F2 minus F1. And it is asked in the question, what is the value of F1? So F1 is equal to F2 minus B. So if I solve this, it comes out to be 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho g. So option 4 is the correct answer. So the correct answer for question number 6 is option 4. Let's move to question number 7. In question number 7, a cubical open tank of height h is equal to 4a is completely filled with a liquid of density rho. There is a square shaped gate of side length a on the side wall adjacent to the bottom of the tank as shown. The torque exerted by the liquid on gate about baseline. So this is the baseline. So we have to calculate what is the torque about this baseline on this square gate of edge length small a. So let, if I consider a small segment, suppose if I consider a strip at a distance x of length dx. So this length is let dx and this is x. So the force acting on the strip df is equal to pressure, that is rho gx, because the atmospheric pressure is 0, into area. So let area of this strip is a into dx, because edge length of this square gate is a and the length of this strip is, and the width of this strip is dx, so the area is adx. So this df is at outward. So if I consider the torque about this baseline, so torque about this baseline d tau is equal to df into this separation is 4a minus x. So net torque acting on the square gate is equal to integration of d tau. Variable is x, which varies from 3a to 4a. So if I solve this, it comes out to be 5 by 3 rho g into a raised to the power. So option 4 is the correct answer. So the correct answer for question number 7 is option 4. Let's move to question number 8. In question number 8, a satellite is revolving around Earth E in an elliptical orbit of eccentricity half with time period capital T. The time taken by the satellite to reach from point A to point B as shown in the figure. So this is the path of the satellite. So if I calculate the area swept by the position vector of the satellite with respect to Earth, then this is the area swept. So I can find out this area A dash is equal to pi AB by 2 is the area of this complete part minus, if I subtract this area, so this is equal to half into this separation is AE into this separation is B. So total separation AB is 2b. The value of E is equal to half. So if I cancel B by half, So it comes out to be AB by 2 into pi minus 1. From Kepler's law, we know that dA by dt is equal to L by 2m and it is equal to constant. So if the time period of the satellite revolving in the elliptical path is capital T, so I can say that total area swept is pi AB divided by capital T, and this ratio must be equal to A dash divided by small t. So substituting the value of A dash, we get the value of small t, and it comes out to be T by 2 into 1 minus 1 by pi. So option 3 is the correct answer. So the correct answer for question number 8 is option 3. Let's move to question number 9. In question number 9, a particle of mass m is released from rest from position A as shown in the figure. The ring is uniform of mass m and radius r. The speed of the particle when it reaches to point B is. Since the particle of mass m is moving only under the gravitational force, so we can apply the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. The initial mechanical energy at this point is equal to the final mechanical energy at this point. So the initial kinetic energy is zero, and the initial potential energy of this system can be written as minus capital G capital M small m by 3R. When the particle reaches to this position, let the velocity is V. So this is equal to half m V square plus gravitational potential energy of these two particles as a system can be written as minus G capital M small m by 2R. So if I solve for the value of V, it comes out to be under root G capital M by 3R. So option 1 is the correct answer. So the correct answer for question number 9 is option 1. Let's move to question number 10. In question number 10, a vessel filled with water up to height h is kept on a table of height h by 2 as shown in the figure. At what height from the bottom of the vessel a small hole is to be made so that range of afflux water on ground is maximum? Let the hole is made at this point, and if I say the position of the hole from the ground is at a distance h, so the velocity of the afflux water from here is equal to under root of 2g into this separation is 3h by 2, so 3h by 2 minus small h. When the water ejects out with this afflux velocity, the velocity in the vertical direction is zero, so the time taken by this jet to reach the ground is equal to under root of 2h by g. So the range on the ground can be written as v into t, so it is equal to 2 times under root of 3h by 2 into h minus h square. So in order to maximize the value of range on the ground, dr by dh must be equal to 0, and if I solve this, the point of maxima comes at h is equal to 3h by 4. So from here the separation is 3h by 4. So from the bottom of the vessel, this separation h dash is equal to h by 4. So option 2 is the correct answer. So the correct answer for question number 10 is option 2. Let's move to question number 11.